Point number seven. Point number six. Sorry, before we go into that, what's the minimum that a surah can be? The minimum a surah can be is how much? Three. Three is the bare minimum. Three is the bare minimum, as the scholars mentioned. The Qur'an is a miracle. In what way? It's a miracle in the wording and the meaning together. The wording and the what? And the meaning together. Another issue that the author, rahimahullah, he spoke about, he said, ثُمَّ مِنْهُ فَاضِلٌ وَهُوَ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ فِي اللَّهِ وَمَفْضُولٌ وَهُوَ كَلَامُهُ تَعَالَى فِي غَيْرِهِ. Suyuti mentioned something else, the virtue of the Qur'an. And he said that the Qur'an is not the same in virtue. The Qur'an is not the same in what? The Qur'an is not the same in virtue. Part of the Qur'an is more virtuous than the other part of the Qur'an. So which part of the Qur'an is more virtuous than the other? He said that the part which is more virtuous is the speech of Allah that talks about Allah. He said that's the most virtuous. And the speech that talks about other than Allah Azza wa Jalla is less virtuous. The speech of Allah that talks about other than Allah is less virtuous. And the speech of Allah that talks about Allah is more virtuous. And that speech, that statement of his is incorrect. Oh, after you guys wrote it now. It's incorrect. Why is it? What can constitute what is virtuous or not is again tawqifiyyah. It's taken from Allah and his messenger. Allah will say that this is more virtuous than this one. Because if he gives a principle like that, wherever you come in the Qur'an, where Allah is speaking about himself, you will automatically say, this is better than this verse. And you have no rights to do that. Are we all together, brothers? It is Allah, the one who determines what is more virtuous than what verse is virtuous than which. That's number one, point number one. Point number two, let me finish. Point number two. The Shaykh is kind of alluding to that the issue of virtues is an amrun ijtihadiyun. It's an ijtihadi related issue, when it's not an ijtihadi related issue. An example for that is, what's the best surah in the Quran? Yeah? What's the best surah in the Quran? Surah Al-Fatiha, correct? Fatiha, half of it talks about Allah and the other half doesn't talk about Allah. Based on the hadith, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ. I divided Surah Al-Fatiha in two halves. Half is Allah's and half is the creation. Surah Al-Ikhlas is all of it's Allah. مَعَ ذَلِكَ Surah Al-Fatiha is better. Are you with me, brothers? You have questions too? What's your question? We can say that this surah, one of the reasons why it's virtuous is because it has the names of Allah mentioned this much times. La shaka, we can say that. But we can't give a general ruling and say that an ayah, a surah, is more virtuous than another based on this criteria alone. No. This issue is tawqifi. Allah tells us what is more virtuous than which. And his messenger tells us it. So it's not a mas'ala ijtihadiyun, where a scholar looks at a verse and he says, I realize that this verse speaks about Allah more than this verse, so it's better than this verse. Are you with me, brothers? That's not permissible. Another thing is, some scholars have held the opinion, can the speech of Allah be virtuous part of it than another? Because when you say the Quran, this verse surah is better than this surah, you're in essence saying Allah's speech here is better than his speech here. Are you allowed to say that? Some scholars, they said, just because a virtue was mentioned for a particular surah doesn't make the other surah mafdulun, low in rank, because that surah can be higher than this surah in something else. Are you with me, brothers? And they say it's not nice to refer to the Qur'an فَاضِلٌ وَمَفْضُولٌ. Are you with me, brothers? Some scholars, they say that. Some scholars are of that opinion. They say that what you say is, if Ayatul Kursi is better than all the other surahs in this issue, then other ayahs might be better than Ayatul Kursi in another issue. Okay? Another issue that the author goes into, which is the seventh issue, yeah? The seventh issue, which he mentions is, وَتَحْرِيمُ قِرَاءَتُهُ, it is prohibited to read the Qur'an, بِالْعَجَمِيَّةِ, in a foreign language, وَبِالْمَعْنَنْ, and it's also prohibited to read it by meaning, وَتَفْسِيرُهُ بِالْرَأِي, and also to read it in terms of opinion. Three things the author mentions that you can't do regarding the speech of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Write this down. Everyone write this down. It's important. The author goes into mentioning three things that you can't do, that are prohibited, that are haram. The first one is tahrimu qira'at al-Qur'an bil-ajamiyyah. You can't read the Qur'an in another language. You can't. Because Allah said in the Qur'an, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنذِرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍ مُبِينٍ. The Qur'an is in the Arabic language. بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍ مُبِينٍ. You're not allowed to read it in another language. That's the first prohibited thing that he mentioned. The second thing that he said that is prohibited is reciting the Qur'an based on meaning. You forgot a verse and you say, I know what the meaning was, let me just use my own wordings, as long as I come up with the meaning, no problem. No. You cannot read the Qur'an based on meaning. You forgot a verse and you say, I know it was talking about, instead of saying, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا, you don't remember it, so you say, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. إِنَّهُ, the dhamir goes back to who? It goes back to the human. But you said, I'll just bring the word in. The ism dhahir is said, the dhamir. You're not allowed to. The Qur'an is verbatim, word for word, haraka, letter, everything. No playing around with it. You have to bring it as it is. Are you with me, brothers? You can't put one verse before the other, one letter before the other. Everything, leave it the way it is. You cannot put one before the other and delay another one from it. So this brings us to a very important issue, which is the Qur'an is talaqqi and sama'. The Qur'an is heard, and that's how it's taken. لَيْسَتْ بِالِجْتِهَادِ وَالِبْتِدَاعِ. The Qur'an is not read based on your ijtihad and innovation. No. The Qur'an, if you're reading it, you have to have evidence for it. If you're going to read it like this, you need to have evidence for it. Are you with me, brothers? What's the evidence for that? The evidence for that is the hadith of Amr ibn al-Harith ibn al-Mustaliqin. He said that the Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ أَحَبَّ, anyone who loves, and يقرأ القرآن, anyone who wants to read the Quran, pay attention. غضبًا كما أنزل, as it was sent down, the Quran sent down as it was. فليقرأ على قراءة ابن أم عبد. Let him recite the recitation of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Read in the recitation of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه. Another example to show you that the Quran is taken, it's passed on, is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Abdullah ibn Sakhbaratia, Abu Ma'marin, he said, Sami'tu ibn Mas'udin. I heard Abdullah ibn Mas'udin, Yaqulu, saying, Allamani Rasulullah, the messenger taught me, At-tashahuda, the messenger taught me the tashahud, Kama yu'allimuni surata min al-Qur'ani, the way he taught me a surah from the Qur'an. Meaning he taught me the tashahud, the way he taught me the Qur'an. Meaning the Qur'an was taken from the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Are you with me, brothers? Also, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ يُعَلِّمُنَا التَّشَهُدَ كَمَا يُعَلِّمُنَا سُورَةً مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. The letters of the tashahud, the way we're reading it, the way I'm reading my tashahud, I heard it from the Prophet, the way I took the Qur'an from the Prophet. Are we all together, brothers? So all of this, what does it show? It shows that the Qur'an is taken. As a side point, 3 minutes. As a side point, what's the ruling in tajweed now? We have to come to that concept of tajweed right now, sah? Where the person reads the Qur'an with tajweed. The mistakes that happen in the Qur'an are two types. Al-lahnu al-khafi and al-lahnu al-jali. There is a big mistake you can do, okay? And there's a hidden mistake a person can do. An apparent mistake and a hidden mistake. If it's an apparent mistake, then you have to learn tajweed for it. It's changing the meaning. It's distorting the meaning. Are we all together? You have to. What do you have to do? You have to take it from a teacher who corrects your pronunciation. This is obligatory. Okay? Because Allah said in the Qur'an, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا وَلِذَلِكَ جَزَرِي. What does he say? وَمَنْ لَمْ يُجَوِّدْ. Anyone who doesn't recite the Qur'an in tajweed, he's what? He's athim, he said, he's a sinner. That's the meaning that will change the Qur'an. The second type of mistake that can happen to the recitation of the Qur'an is called al-lahnu al-khafi. It's a hidden mistake. Okay, it's not apparent, it's a hidden mistake. That's the one where it's connected to the med and how long it is. It won't change the meaning. It's also connected to the things like that. This doesn't have a problem. And that is not the one where you're a sinner if you don't read it like that. You will still consider to be a reciter based on the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said, the one who recites the Qur'an, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنَ وَهُوَ حَافِظٌ لَهُ مَعَ سَفَرَةِ الْكَرَامَةِ الْبَرَرَةِ. He's with the angels. وَمَثَلُ الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ. And the one who recites the Qur'an, وَهُوَ يَتَعَاهَدُ. He's trying his hardest to read it. وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَاقٌ. And it's hard on him. It's heavy on him. فَلَهُ أَجْرَانِ. He has two rewards. The Prophet referred to the one who was struggling to have how many rewards? Double the reward. Two rewards. He was still called a reciter. Okay? And then we'll go into the next part, inshallah, after the salah. Bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. So there were three things that I said that the author, rahimahullah, concluded with. The first one was the prohibition of reciting the Qur'an in a foreign language. Number two, the prohibition of reciting the Qur'an in what? By meaning, based on meaning. And the third, which we're going to go into now, is the prohibition of commenting on the Qur'an based on opinion. Okay? In another language, in English. تحريم تفسير القرآن بالرأي نعم. Not translation. The Quran. Can you read the Quran? Can you read the Quran in English instead of having to pray the salah praying the salah with Fatiha? You say in the name of God, the Most Merciful, the Most Gracious. The translation, not the tafsir. Are you allowed to? It's a problem from a side point, because you don't learn to read properly from the transliteration. Let's leave the questions to the end. I lose my focus. Point number three. تَحْرِيمُ تَفْسِيرُ الْقُرْآنِ بِالرَّأْيِ. The prohibition of commenting on the Qur'an based on opinion. Okay? What does that actually mean, tafsir of the Qur'an based on opinion? Before I go into it, let me just mention the sources of some of the books that have tafsir of the Qur'an based on opinion, like the tafsir of Al-Zamakhshari, Al-Kashshaf. Also the tafsir book known as Al-Haqa'iq Al-Tafsir, Li-Abi Abdurrahman Al-Sulami. These tafsir and other tafsir written by Shia and Khawarij and Sufiya and others, these tafsir books are the books that are called tafsir bil-ra'i, based on opinion, mere opinions. Okay? Because they haven't met the conditions of accepting their tafsir based on... You see, tafsir bil-ra'i is two types. Opinions is two types. Al-ra'i which is mahmud and al-ra'i which is madhmum. Opinions that's praiseworthy and opinions which is blameworthy. The opinion which is praiseworthy is when it reaches, I mean, when five conditions are met, five conditions are found, then the tafsir bil-ra'yi here is praiseworthy. It's praiseworthy. The first one is Allah yukhalifa tafsir bil-ma'thuri mukhalifatun tudadu. It should oppose the tafsir bil-ma'thur, an opposition that you can't reconcile between the two. This tafsir should not oppose a tafsir that has texts. Okay? We can't. So your ijtihad on the ayah, what it means, it shouldn't oppose a athar, a text that has come. Number two, أَلَّا يُخَالِفَ سِيَاقَ الْآيَةِ وَسِبَاقِهَا. It should not oppose the verse that you're commenting on, the verse after it and the verse before it. It shouldn't go against any of the two. The sibaq means the part before it and the part after it. Number three, Allah yukhalifa dalalatul alfadhi min jihati al-lugha. It should not oppose that which you study in usul al-fiqh. Aam, khas, mutlaq, muqayyad, mujmal, mubayyan. The dalalatul alfadh, general text, specific text, things like that. It should not go against what you study in dalalatul alfadh. Meaning it shouldn't oppose the Arabic language, basically. It shouldn't go against the Arabic language. Like the Shia who say, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُ بَقَرًا. Allah is commanding you, Musa, to slaughter a cow. The Shia, they said that the cow here is Aisha. What dictionary book is that? Where would that be? It's not a language. It has no meaning. Are you with me, brothers? Oh, when they said, فَقَاتِلُوا أَئِمَّةَ الْكُفْرِ إِنَّهُمْ لَا أَيْمَانَ لَهُمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَنْتَهُونَ. They said, فَقَاتِلُوا, fight with أَئِمَّةَ الْكُفْرِ. أَئِمَّةَ الْكُفْرِ is Abu Bakr and Umar. Where? In what context? Where? So this tafsir is not, it's not tafsir which is accepted. It won't be accepted. Okay? The fourth condition is, أَلَّا يُقَوِّيَ أَقْوَالُ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ. This tafsir should not strengthen the opinion of the people of innovation. It can't strengthen the opinion of innovators. Like, remember here, by the way, when you say that it can't strengthen the opinion of the innovators, like for example, the Shia believe Ali ibn Abi Talib is a what? They respect him method and they love him, right? So we can't negate all of the verses and reject the verses that speak about the virtue of Ali, right? Are you with me, brothers? Because for us, that's not, it's not innovation. Ali is an honorable companion to us, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, sah? So sometimes people might run away from something, but it's present in our own belief. We love Ali radiallahu anhu, and we love Fatima. And any ayats that support them, we love those verses. And we won't change it for anyone. Does that make sense? So what it means, Allah yuqawi aqwal ahl al-bid'ah, means something that they believe that has no text for it. The ayah should not support, your interpretation should not support their belief. Okay? And last but not least is, Allah yakhruj ani al-ma'ani al-shar'iyyah. It shouldn't go outside the definition that the sharia has given in things. Other than that, tafsir al-ra'yi is permissible if it meets those five conditions. At-tafsir bil-ra'yi, tafsir based on opinions, is permissible if it meets those five conditions. And one of the scholars whose book is tafsir al-ma'thuri and also tafsir bil-ra'yi at the same time is Ibn Kathir. Okay, Ibn Kathir, his tafsir is ma'thur and it's bil-ra'yi, both at the same time. And so one doesn't eliminate the other because he's meeting these conditions now. That's why the first condition was what? Allah yukhalifa tafsiru bil ma'thuri. It can't go against the text. Text to me means Qur'an, Sunnah, aqwalu sahaba, which is a text that was transmitted to us, or the tabi'in. It can't go against them, na'am. Are we all together? Then the tafsiru is how many types? It's two types, tafsir al-ra'i and tafsir al-ma'thuri. The Shaykh here, Jaladin al-Suyuti, he broke it into three. Tafsir al-ma'thuri, tafsir al-ta'wili, and tafsir al-ra'i. Are you with me, brothers? Suyuti broke it into those three. Tafsir al-ma'thuri, tafsir al-ta'wili, and tafsir al-ra'i. And why did he do bitta'wili? He wants to say that bitta'wili is the good tafsir bil-ra'i. And the tafsir bil-ra'i is the bad tafsir bil-ra'i. Does that make sense? That's why he said that. Naam.
قال السيوطي رحمه الله والأنواع منها ما يرجع إلى النزول وهو 12 نوعا.
The author, rahimahullah, he now goes into the types of Qur'an that came down. How much does he mention? He says, it's how many? He says, وَهُوَ اثْنَا عَشَرَ نَوْعَى. It's 12. There are 12 types of descending of the Qur'an. Are we all together? Lakin, in his other book, which is known as a tahbir, Suyuti mentions 20 types. And he also mentions it in his itqan fi ulum al-Qur'an. And they are, al-naw'u al-awwal wa-thani, al-makki wa-al-madani, al-thalith wa-al-rabi'u al-hadari wa-al-safari wa-al-khamis wa-al-sadis wa-al-nahari wa-al-layli. السابع والثامن الصيفي والشتائي التاسع والعاشر الفراشي والنومي الحادي عشر أسباب النزول الثاني عشر أول ما نزل الثالث عشر آخر ما نزل الرابع عشر ما عرف وقت نزوله الخامس عشر ما أنزل فيه ولم ينزل على أحد من الأنبياء السادس عشر ما أنزل منه على الأنبياء السابع عشر ما تكرر نزوله الثامن عشر ما نزل مفرقا التاسع عشر ما نزل جمعا العشرون كيفية إنزاله. These 20 are what he mentioned in his kitab, At-Tahbir. And we're going to take from those how much? We're going to take from that, inshaAllah ta'ala, 12 bi-ibni Allahil Kareem. Knowing the Qur'an that came down, knowing that the Qur'an that came down is important. Because the chapter here is Ma'rifatu ma nazala min al-Qur'an, right? Knowing what came down from the Qur'an. First of all, the statement of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala shows that the Qur'an came down. Let me read some ayats which mention that the Qur'an came down. And then I'm going to comment on it, inshaAllah ta'ala. Allah says in Surah Al-An'am, وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ مُصَدِّقُ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَلِتُنذِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَى وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَهُمْ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. So at the beginning of that verse, what does Allah say? وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ. We sent it down. Again, Allah says in Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 155. Try to write those verses down, inshallah. The first verse was Surah Al-An'am 92. Surah Al-An'am 92. Allah mentioned that Quran came down. In Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 155, Allah says, وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. 155. In Surah Al-An'am. Surah Yusuf, Ayah 2, Allah says, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ. We sent it down. Surah Yusuf, Ayah 2. Surah Al-Isra, Ayah 5. Allah tells us that He sent the Qur'an down. He says, Surah Al-Isra, Ayah 100 and? What did I say at the beginning? 105. Sah, correct. وَبِالْحَقِّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ وَبِالْحَقِّ نَزَلْ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. In Surah Al-Nahl, Ayah 102, Allah says, قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ مِنْ رَبِّكَ بِالْحَقِّ لِيُثَبِّتَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَهُدًى وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ سورة الإسراء آية 106 الله says وَقُرْآنًا فَرَقْنَاهُ لِتَقْرَأَهُ عَلَى النَّاسِ عَلَى مُكْثٍ وَنَزَّلْنَاهُ تَنْزِيلًا سورة البقرة آية 97 الله says قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَى قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ على قلبك بإذن الله مصدقا لما بين يديه وهدى وبشرى للمؤمنين سورة الإنسان آية 23 الله says إنا نحن نزلنا عليك القرآن تنزيلا All of those verses Allah used the word النزول نزل نزول نزول that term نزول The Qur'an came down from Allah Azza wa Jalla. And the reason why I'm mentioning all of that is because there are some people who don't want to accept that the Qur'an came down. They don't want to accept it. It came down from Allah high above. Okay? وَلِذَلِكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ ibn Taymiyyah, he said, لَيْسَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ It is not in the Qur'an. وَلَا فِي السُنَّةِ And there is no... And it's not in the sunnah. لَفْظُ نُزُولِ The term نُزُول illa wa fihi except that the word nuzul means an-nuzul al-ma'ruf the nuzul that everyone knows the descending the word nuzul is not in the Quran and the sunnah except it is what you all know descending wa hadha huwa al-la'iq bil-Quran and that is what is befitting to the Quran fa innahu nazzala bi-lughati al-arabi it came down in the Arabic language came down in the Arabic language wa la ta'rifu al-arabu and the Arabs don't No, nuzulan, the word nuzul, the Arabs don't know it, illa bihadha al-ma'na, except this meaning, which is descending. That's all they know it as. وَلَوْ أُرِيدَ غَيْرُ هَذَا And if it was in the Qur'an, the word nuzul was meant by something other than descending, if that was it, لَكَانَ خِطَابًا بِغَيْرُ لُغَتِهَا Then Allah would have said it in another language. It would have been spoken in another language. ثُمَّ هُوَ اسْتِعْمَالُ اللَّفْظِ الْمَعْرُوفِ لَهُ مَعْنًا فِي مَعْنًا آخَرِ بِلَا بَيَانٍ وَهَذَا لَا يَجُوزُ وبهذا يحصل مقصود القرآن واللغة الذي أخبر الله تعالى أنه بينه وجعله هدى للناس انتهى كلامه. إذن the point is the Quran came down and that means that Allah تبارك وتعالى is high above and the Quran came down from Him سبحانه وتعالى. The Jahmiyyah a deviated group and the Qadariyyah another deviated group. They said that the word نزول القرآن means خلق القرآن. Allah created the Quran. That's their belief. And 500 scholars made takfir of the Khawarij. Jahmiyyah. 500. Okay? Ibn Nuqayyah mentions them, irrahimahullah, in his Nuniyah. Another group known as the Kullabiyyah and other groups, they said that the Quran, and the Sha'irah, they said that the Quran came down means Allah proclaimed, it got announced. Okay? It got announced. And the angel brought out his understanding from high above. The angel brought it from high above. The angel was above. And it came from his understanding. And that's what we got the Quran from. All of that is because they don't want to affirm Allah is what? Allah is above, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We, Ahlul Sunnah, say the Quran came down from Allah. نُثْبِتُ مَعَانِيهَا الظَّاهِرَ We affirm the apparent meaning that is in the word نُزُول, descending. We affirm the apparent meaning in it, وَنُفَوِّضُ الْكَيْفِيَّةَ إِلَى اللَّهِ And we attribute to Allah the how. We don't know how it came down. The how, we don't know. We say Allah knows how it came down. But we accept the word nuzul means coming down and descending.